Okay. Just gonna make sure that my friends list is off, and it's not, so let's do that. Well, last run with the flame mech did sort of crash and burn there, so that sort of sucks. But I think I got to show off a good deal what the flame tank's all about. Basically, it's like, you know, less about the like item gathering and more about the, you know, upfront just kill everything that moves. Anyhow, I think we'll go into Indigo Dipole here next. This guy's basically a little bit of a defensive type of like mech, I guess we'll say he is. He basically has like mines, and he has magnetism, basically, which basically lets his missile launcher pull stuff into it. I really don't like the Indigo Dipole, but it does have its uses, so I'll basically show it off, I guess. And yes, all the lovely stuff over here. So here we are, the Indigo Dipole. We have access to a basic minigun. Which I could replace with a phaser gun, which basically pierces enemies and walls. Sure, why not? So here's the thing that basically pierces walls. The minigun hits walls, this thing will pass through them. Alright, so here's a couple of things to know about this mech. Basically, this mech has like a sort of mine you can place. And it'll deflect enemy bullets that basically pass around it or explode when an enemy goes around it. So, trying to show it off a little bit. And there's this missile launcher. There's a keycard holder, but whatever, we can't do anything about it. Robot shop, basic shop. We'll get that, and maybe we'll get this one get a chance. Oh, look at that, we found ourselves a freedom thing here. Alright, so we can get the Kunai, short range stabbing weapon, charge to throw. I don't think I care about that. The repulsive mine is pretty good to keep, so we'll actually make use of it, I think. And I'm gonna pick that weapon up because if I pick up this weapon, as you can see, it's gonna cause the REM, so we should include this, I think, to disappear, so. Just gonna leave it alone. Oops, I accidentally pressed the right mouse button there. See, I can, like, do this, as you can see, and like it basically causes damage when guys run over it. So it's a mine. Also, there's other stuff too. Like, what basically is for? It's basically for defense. The mine. Yeah, I'm having difficulty hitting this guy because, you know, can't go close, and the stupid thing is like being flanked by the red stuff. Alright, so this weapon, by the way, I've got, I'll note that as it passes through stuff, so it won't pass through this stuff, but I hit these guys without any worry. Very cheap weapon to use, basically, in some situations. Credits. I go back for a health share if I want to now, I guess. Nice missiles. Let's go see a little bit more. The only bad thing about this is that it's really hard to hit stuff with it. This weapon. That worked out well. Lose all energy to instantly damage all enemies. Sure, I'll show that off. Oh, okay. Now, here's something I'm gonna note, by the way. The last time I've been like going through these health, like, you know, sacrifice shops to basically pick up stuff and like show them off, I'm gonna try actually leaving them alone. See, like, actually, basically, if I don't visit them, will the stuff not spawn until later levels, perhaps? Because, you know, I don't have a lot of health to basically sacrifice and stuff early on, so maybe if I wait a little bit later, might be a little bit better. See how the game works, perhaps. Alright, there's the boss. Twin machine guns, dual shot with average rate of fire, but high ammo capacity. Oh, this is gonna be fun. So, I'll note that if you find like secondary weapons that you can fire like constantly like this, these are really awesome to have. So, you know what we're gonna do? We're actually gonna keep this for now. I'll basically try to show off the energy thing a little bit more. Alright, battle swarm. Basically, here's how like the mime works. If like stuff tries to get close to it, it can't. So it can use it sort of like a defense. A temporary defense. Now, here's another thing about this mech. Because it's basically got magnetic like missile launchers, if you fire a missile, they'll basically pull stuff into it like that. All right, so there goes Battle Swarm. There's a key card, cool. Alright, so I want to get Brute more damage. And we'll pick that up. So you basically saw what the mine's all about. That basically is what this mech is kind of cool for. That, like, you know, mine ability, which basically you can use to basically deflect shots or, like, you know, tactically kill enemies. I don't consider it to be the strongest thing, but, you know, it's strong enough to say the least. Okay, let's use up my special ability here. So if I fire, there goes all my energy by damage directly in the room. Oh, I took a hit. Health back. Okay, got rid of him. Nope. Yeah, fire for the wall. Hey, look at that, he laid missiles for me. No lack of missiles for this level. Alright, so at this point, I think I'm more or less Explorer if I'm going to. Showing off the special abilities of his mech already. At this point, I think it's all about just sort of like making, you know, as far as I can. Showing off what I can, you know, as I get along. And that weapon's gonna be fun to use. Yeah, by the way, this guy is an Emmy in some, you know, most situations. I kind of wish he wasn't Emmy until you decide he was an Emmy, but whatever. Pick that up. I'm not missing anything else in this room, am I? Think so. Very few health shards to pick up this time around. Alright, there we go, full missiles. Collect all health shards before leaving the floor for a bonus. Alright, reduce energy cost by 20%, that's cool. Means I can fire off my weapon a lot more. The mine's cool, by the way, but, you know, I prefer, like, you know, weapons like this, which you can fire a whole lot, because they, I find them more useful. Alright, we got a hunter. A cool thing here about this guy is that... apparently getting stuck on walls. This guy's more or less designed to have his, like, you know, he just follows you, but I guess if he's got issues trying to follow you. Well, that's fun. And yeah, I like this weapon. It's nice and cheap, isn't it? Sure, 5% chance to avoid taking damage when hit. You know what? Double health would be nice. Let's get that. So I can heal up more. Oopsie. Back too close to this guy. This is the perfect weapon for a serious scenario, but I'm not doing very well because all the enemies being so close right away. I did terribly there. Watch me perform terribly, that's what I'm doing right here. Oh well. Such a nice OST to listen to, at least. Alright, there you go, full health. Here's the Crystal Mutter. This boss is pretty easy to fight. Thank you. Weave and move. Oh, what the? Let's just finish it off. This is where, like, you know, it's good to have, like, energy weapons you can fire quickly. You can do a whole lot of extra damage to finish stuff off quickly. More damage! More damage! Yeah, I could go to the next level, but let's stick around to try and find some more stuff to make use of, I guess. Shopkeeper, apparently. Get more of that stuff. Whoops. This is stupid. Oh. The terrain is hurting me quite a bit. Well, that was fun. Was there our health sacrifice shop, but we'll avoid it because I still don't have a lot of health. Wall beam. I can't fire through his shot, so. Four health on upgrades, very nice. Or four health on pickup, very nice. There we go. Very boxy this level. I'll say that. Yay! Another health. 9 health. More crits. And we got him. Yeah, look at all the health I would have missed if I didn't take the rest of this level out. Extra health. Extra health, extra experience, extra items. Let's see, we got the hot rod, RMs, blah, blah, blah. All right, leave a trail of fire whenever you sprint. The hunter killer fires 3 needles at home after ram enemies. That's interesting. And railgun module, increased main gun bolt spread and range, adds extra shots. I think I like the idea of the hot rod the best from these stuff. So let's get that. So whenever you sprint, flame on! So I'll note that of all the mechs, this is probably my least favorite mech. I mean, it's kind of cool. You can, like, you know, usually like the it's like initial mind to like, you know, have a lot of fun with it, but I think this bear mechs are basically the play. I think my favorite mech is the flame mech, even though I lost a bit. You gotta love the fact that with the flame mech you can just go around annihilating everything. Oh god, this is gonna hurt. Yes. Oh, this is painful. Why is there so many of these guys initially? Alright, let's take you out next. Oh god, he came right through there. Let's see here. More health, please. Because I'm so critically injured, I have to go find like the little ramp bits of health left around. I'll leave those missiles on for now. Pick up that health. There we go, full health. Well, that extra health, you know, I'm getting is coming to good use. Making some mistakes for some reason. But whatever. At least my keyboard isn't killing me this time around. That's an improvement. You have no idea how much more annoying it is to be, like, you know, taking shots you can't avoid than to be making mistakes that you could. Until you experience, you know, it. Alright, let's fire. Fire, fire! That up now. Whee! Flames! The flames! I'm enjoying my flame walk a little bit too much. Him. Pick that up. That up. All right, defensive shop. Why not look in here? Nice, except I don't have the money for it. Damn it. I wish you could sell stuff. I'll say it right now. I'm gonna have to pass it up because I don't have the money for it. Well, on to next level, I guess. I wonder if I got a bonus for that. I wonder how the bonuses work in this game, actually. There's a lot of stuff that, you know, it's not very, like, you know, evident what it's all about. Like, buy all items from a cheap shop before entering the next floor for a bonus. Zoom, zoom, zoom! That was fun. I really have to say, I don't usually like this mech, but because of the weapons I've got, I'm actually, you know, enjoying the run at least for the weapons I've currently got. Really a fire through walls. Got this thing if I need it. That guy. There we go. Now I can break through unbreakables with my flame walk now. Most of them. These ones at least. Ow. Oh! I didn't see this guy until it's too late. Oh! Okay, this thing needs to die. Strike Guardian. You know what? Let's do this. You're having trouble, start using your energy weapon. That's fun. There we go, all dead. Big leaky battery. You know, this is a very interesting weapon, but it basically requires that you use your energy really, really fast, so I don't pick it up usually. Basically, when you have this on, you'll start losing energy. You know, basically as soon as you enter a room. That's not very good if you need to save it up for, like, you know, the ward and stuff like that, so I don't usually get it, but, you know, it's there. No reason to go stay in here, I guess. Crap, crap, crap. Ow. 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 There's nothing fun about this room. There we go. My mouse is, or my keyboard's starting to go again. Weapons shop, don't care. There we go, full health. It's a good thing I picked up that ability. Suck. That's being slowly dying, those. Oh god, look at all this stuff. Yeah, I got stuck. About time to get stuck. Yeah, in this day and age, wireless is just, you know, it's getting destroyed by Wi-Fi and stuff. That guy's out of the way. So much stuff to avoid. Oh, look at that, he came right to me. He's out of the way. Wait, and they will come to you. Well, that was fun. Not. Lasers destroy a lot of these bricks, so you know. I'll be picking that up for now. 4% chance to receive double credits from drops. You know, I'm more of this ability right here is actually giving you more health and our stuff like they did on the other mech, the flame mech. Oh, that's easy. Well, full health now, I guess. Oops. I took a hit. Didn't fret it very well. Okay, time to get out of here. Health upgrade shop, that's cool. Gotta find some key cards to open that up, I guess. We'll save those missiles. Alright, let's go up, I guess. Up I go. No, that's not the keyboard asking me that time. Just scratched my head because it's getting itchy. Double pack. Major item storage, another thing for key cards. Hey, key card. Nope, not enough range. Oh, there we go. Great, there's another one up there, of course. These are like new enemies, but they're really annoying. To say the least. Oh, got his attention. Yeah, let's waste the missile to kill him. Demense! Oh, there are enemies somewhere. Oh, of course, more Demense! That was fun. Yes. All right, let's go get our health, I guess. Other goodies. Let's go up here. I want to see if I can get this before I forget about it. I was hoping I could thread a needle there, but whatever. Well, that took a lot of extra damage I need to. Oh well. Yoink! Shattering module. Unit of explosive damage has slow but high damage control your main gun. More damage! Let's get these missiles, I guess. I feel like I can. Whoops. Died. Alright, I'm being an idiot now. Alright, health. Alright, so here's shield transfer. I don't usually like shield transfer, but it's a good way to get more health if you can get it. So there's more ways to get more shields than there is to lose health like that, so I'm probably gonna find a way to get more shields eventually in the run. Alright, well, I guess it's just down. And that'll be it for this first episode of Starward Road. I hit it. I'll run that. Health upgrade, health sacrifice shop. I'm tempted to open up these locked loot chests, but not with like one key card, so I'll just keep that around for now, I guess. Kill that. Shoot. Oh, I took some damage there. Alright, there's the boss. We're gonna go get our health, I guess, first. I is the health? There is the health. This is a bit of a waste, but yoink! Alright, let's see what the boss is and go trumpet. Trounce it. Oh, invader. Now, you want to see something really, really easy to do? Because you can shoot through walls. Get some easy shots on him from the get-go. Now, unfortunately, I can't hit him until his, you know, shield goes away, but goes invader. That was probably the easiest time killing invader, but that's just because of the weapon setup. He's one of a few, you know, easy bosses to kill if you have like the ability to shoot through walls, just because that, you know, ability to hit him through the wall. Perfect. Alright, well. More energy. There's the first three floors of the megalith. See how far I can get. Make the next floor without taking any damage anyway for a bonus. That'd be cool. Alright, well, there's like the first episode with the Indigo Dipole. I'm not really showing off its like, you know, basic functions a whole lot, but you know, whatever. We'll see how far I can get. For now, take care.